So now Bob, Carol, and Alice, who's going to come in later, are finally having their meeting. And, well, I should say something about Carol's algorithm, but Carol already has a bit more experience with algorithms than Bob or Alice. So she has already figured out that a simple algorithm that would just try all of the possibilities of selecting certain investment opportunities into her portfolio is just not going to cut it. So Carol is really looking forward to meeting Bob and figuring out some new ideas. So at the beginning of the meeting, Alice is not there yet, Bob and Carol start explaining their problems to each other. So Bob is explaining to Carol how, among a set of genes, some of which are connected, he is looking for groups where every gene is connected to every other gene. And Carol, of course, explains her problem, where she is looking for potential investments that are not connected to each other, such as this one here. Now, in order to not have to talk about genes and investments anymore, we should use some common terminology for both of those problems. And if you already had an algorithms course, you might have come across a structure known as graphs. And graphs are basically just objects that are connected to each other. So the network up here, that would be called a graph. And the network down here would also be called a graph. This here, the object would be called a vertex. And of course, this and all of these objects here are vertices. So this would also be a vertex here, either the purple or the green ones. And then the connections are called edges. So all of the blue connections, or some of those that I've colored green here, every single one of them is an edge. So an edge always connects two vertices, and the whole structure is called a graph. And if you use that terminology, you can state the problems that Bob and Carol are working on using a similar language. So Bob's problem is basically taking as input a graph with n vertices, and the output that he's looking for, and we have to make this bubble a bit bigger for that. The output he's basically looking for is the largest set of vertices all connected to each other. We'll also make the bubble for Carol a bit bigger to state her problem. So what Carol is looking for, again, the input is a graph with n vertices. And the output is the largest set of vertices, not all connected to each other, but none connected to each other. So as you can see, once we use the common terminology, the problem that Bob is working on is actually very, very similar to the one that Carol is working on. The only difference is Bob is looking for a set of vertices where all are connected to each other, and Carol is working on a problem where none of the vertices are connected to each other. But everything else is the same. You're given a graph with n vertices, you're looking for the largest possible set, and all it's about is the connections that these vertices have to each other. So in the future, to be better able to talk about these problems, we'll also give them names, as we do with most problems. Also so that we don't always have to say, this is Bob's problem and this is Carol's problem. What we will call Bob's problem is a problem named click, because all of those vertices are very closely connected to each other, just like in a click of friends, for example. And we'll call Carol's problem independent set. Carol is basically looking for the opposite of a closely connected click. Carol is looking for vertices that are not connected to each other. So if those were friends, they wouldn't know of each other. So now, after Bob and Carol have explained their problems to each other and given it a name, they notice since the only difference between click and independent set is that in one we're looking for all vertices to be connected, and in the other one we're looking for none of the vertices to be connected, their problems are actually very, very closely related. And I will show you the idea that they come up with to figure out how similar those problems are, also from an algorithmic perspective.